Hey, it's Mike Menza from the Roots of Rhythm. Today, we're gonna go way, way back to the beginning of time, the beginning of rock and roll. This magical piece of wood is a 1950 100% original Broadcaster. During that time, most of the guitars made were Gibson hollow body guitars. This was revolutionary for country musicians, rock and rollers, blues musicians. It was something that actually changed the game for music until today. So this is very rare. Very sought after, and maybe one out of 200 guitars we estimate that were made, we're not entirely sure, but you're looking at history. All right, guys, let's take a look at the headstock. Now, as you can tell, you have the beautiful Fender logo, and it says Broadcaster. This was a Fender Broadcaster. Now, I know through the image of the guitar and the shape of the guitar, obviously it's got Telecaster as we know it now, but at that time it was a Broadcaster. And we can talk about the body as well. We have an ash body and a maple neck. And this was the first guitar that was two pieces that were bolted together. And you know what? They didn't know at the time what the outcome was going to be, but I'll tell you what, people started playing them and quickly found out that they sound awesome. So almost 75 years ago, Leo Fender created a whole new world, a whole new genre of music, with this guitar being born into our history of rock and roll. Listen, Keith Richards, when he saw this, he had to have it. We're talking about Jeff Beck. We're talking about Roy Buchanan. I mean, all of the greats played these guitars, and I'm so grateful. And I know you're so grateful for all that music, and it was born from this right here.
All right, a little bit of history about these guitars. In 1950, Leo creates the Broadcaster. It's popular. He's bringing it to every country artist he can find in California to play them. They love them. He builds about 200, we assume. And he gets a call from Gretsch that they own the name Broadcaster. And they said, you're gonna have to, and they were used on a Broadcaster drums. You're gonna have to stop using that name, cease and desist. He's like, okay, what is he gonna do? So, being as cheap as he is, he's got all these other guitars in production. He takes the decals that aren't used yet, and with his scissors, he cuts the name Broadcaster off and uses them anyway. And so he applies them on the next batch of guitars. And we lovingly refer to them as Nocasters, because they just say Fender on them. So he's building these Nocasters without approval for his new name, Telecaster. But he doesn't have the decals yet. I don't know if he has the approval yet, but the next batch of guitars, pretty much exactly the same as a Broadcaster, is a Nocaster in 1951. Okay, he gets the approval and gets his new logos, decals, and so he calls it the Telecaster. Broadcaster, Telecaster, you know, it was back then when Sputnik and television was coming in. So he called them the Telecaster, And they've been a Telecaster, as everyone knows, from 1951 to 2024, as we sit here. Basically, they're still the same. There's a couple of slight electronical changes, and there's one routing change that we're going to show you. On the Broadcaster, the wiring from this pickup to the controls inside is a small hole that he had to channel the wires through, and it became a pain in the neck. Some of the Nocasters, we call this solid in here, but by the time he got to the Telecaster, he had this route underneath the pick guard so that you could feed the wires through to the control plow as you assembled it more easily. So usually on a Broadcaster, there's no channel route. That's how you can tell it's a real Broadcaster body. Nocasters, some of them have the channel route, some of them don't. This one does. And then all the Telecasters have the channel route. All right, basically all three of these guitars are known as Blackguard Tellies. And not much of the design changed, but we'll go into some specifics. They all had the big flat pole pickup that we call in the back. Later on, the pole pieces came up. They all had the old black switch tip, same as you'll find on a tube tester from the 50s. This one's a little transitional in 52. Everything before 52 had flathead screws. But now they started to mix with Phillips head screws. All Tellies string through the body, 52 and earlier flathead screws, after then Phillips head screws. Flat pole stays till 1954. Pickup, front pickup remains the same. All of them had this black pressed, I don't know if it's plastic or what it is. It has this, you know, they turned white in 54. Everything before 54 has the black pickguard. Small frets, solid maple neck, string tree on the other side of Fender. Again, flat pole screw. Flathead screw. If you look, this is single line Cluson, but no name. It's correct for 52. And the skunk stripe. What's the skunk stripe? Well, it looks like a skunk stripe. The skunk stripe is a routed piece out of the neck that the truss rod is inside. The truss rod, as you can see, it's a walnut piece. It's a metal rod, goes through the center, and the adjustment screw, I don't know if you can see it, is right there. And the ash body, these were pretty much white when they were made, but over the years, they aged and the patina became yellow, and we call this butterscotch. And this is a good example. This one's fairly light still, butterscotch. But if you look at the Broadcaster, which is older, you can see the cover was kept on it for a long time. So the original color is still under the cover. You can see how much it's turned butterscotch and how much of the original color was hidden from the light, because it's the light that makes the patina turn darker.
So guys, listen, I don't know if this is ever gonna happen again. Three of these guitars in the same room, a Broadcaster, a Nocaster, and a Telecaster. This is very special. And I'll tell you what, I'm very, very grateful for all of you watching. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel. There'll be many more. And this is really cool. we got some cool stuff coming. So stay tuned. Rock and roll.